I'm Tracy Baxter with today's Record News Watch. A City of Kingston police officer was bitten by a pit bull Sunday when officers attempted to arrest the dog's owner on an outstanding criminal warrant. It happened in the area of Broadway and Field Court in Kingston. Police say an officer spotted the man, 32-year-old David Smith of Olive, walking the dog. When the officer approached, police say Smith released the pit bull. The officer called quickly for backup, and the dog attacked several arriving officers, biting one of them in the hand. Police responded by shooting the pit bull. During the scuffle, Smith was taken into custody after getting tasered. Smith was charged with felony assault, along with resisting arrest, criminal mischief, and obstructing governmental administration. The dog survived the gunshot wound and was being treated at a local animal hospital. Also Sunday, Kingston City Police responded to a shots fired incident in the area of Roundout Garden Apartments. Officers say the suspect had fired a gun at several people at that location. No one was hit, and the subsequent investigation targeted 28-year-old Lawrence Wright of Connolly, who was later tracked down at a gas station in Port Ewan. Wright was charged with felony weapons possession and reckless endangerment. Detectives recovered what they believe was the .45-caliber handgun used in the incident. Sources with the Associated Press are reporting a tentative gun control deal has been reached between Governor Andrew Cuomo and state legislative leaders in response to the Newtown school shootings. The legislation would reportedly place further restrictions on the state's assault weapons ban, would further limit the size of ammunition magazines, and would include harsher penalties for those convicted of gun crimes. Another tentative provision would make changes in the mental health law, allowing for civil confinement of those determined to be a threat to others. The Associated Press report says the tentative deal is being debated behind closed doors today and that the bill could be presented later this week or even as early as today for possible approval. Elsewhere, the Middletown Common Council is considering jail time as a possible sentence for those who repeatedly break the local law prohibiting the riding of bicycles on city sidewalks. Police have written a number of tickets for this offense, especially in the downtown sector, and the law, as it currently stands, does not include jail time as a potential option. As a result, people can avoid paying fines by not going to court because the judge can't issue a bench warrant. Reporter Nathan Brown will have more on the proposed law revision in Middletown in an upcoming edition of the Times-Herald Record. The federal observance of his birthday is next Monday, January 21st. The life and accomplishments of Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King were celebrated Sunday during a program sponsored by the Middletown NAACP and held at St. Paul's United Methodist Church in Middletown. The event included musical performances and speakers who reminded the audience that Dr. King was much more than his "I Have a Dream" speech. Many who spoke said Dr. King would be saddened by the continuing gang violence that has ripped through many of our minority communities. Others said more needs to be done to inspire a new generation to continue the legacy left by the assassinated civil rights leader. Sunday's MLK celebration attracted members of religious congregations from throughout the area. You've heard of the Soapbox Derby. This was the Milk Box Derby. Hothony Mountain Ski Area in Bridgeville played host to the unique fundraiser Saturday. Students from Monticello's Kaiser Middle School created sleds made of half-gallon-sized cardboard milk containers and then raced them down the ski area's tubing hill. Proceeds from the entry and sponsorship fees are going to the family of Alexis Lexi Bivens, a 14-year-old Kaiser Middle School student who's been battling primitive, undifferentiated pediatric sarcoma, a very rare form of childhood cancer. Lexi was there to enjoy the event and to thank those who got involved.
They're all very sweet. I mean, like, out of a girl that wasn't like a nobody, and like having all these people out here, it really feels good.
She has such a fan base in the school. She's got such a dynamic personality. Everybody loved her. Everybody was really upset about what she had to go through. So I think a lot of the kids that couldn't be here have been in spirit and supporting her.
Besides awards for the fastest milk box, prizes were also awarded to the most creatively designed milk box derby entry. Organizers were hoping to raise $2,000 to help the Bivens family with ongoing treatment expenses. Lexi's back at school and is optimistic that she will beat her cancer. And Elvis was in the building. The building in this case, ShopRite in Monticello. That's where local Elvis impersonator Eric Bressy was entertaining shoppers while raising the money and food for the Church of the Nazarene in Rock Hill. Those who stopped by were encouraged to buy a few items to donate to the church's food pantry, which has been adversely impacted by the economy, the demands of the holiday season, and donations diverted to victims of Hurricane Sandy. Bressy belted out favorite Elvis tunes during his 90-minute benefit performance. This was a return engagement for Elvis Bressy. He also performed last year at ShopRite to help feed needy folks in our area. Colder weather will return to the region this week. Tuesday will be mostly cloudy with temperatures topping out in the upper 30s to around 40 degrees. Wednesday will be partly sunny with the highs again in the neighborhood of 40 degrees. When news breaks, you will find it here at Record Online. And you'll get the news and information you need to start your day when you pick up the Times Herald Record tomorrow morning. For Record News Watch, I'm Tracy Baxter. ¶¶